Hi, and welcome to How to Use a Tax Table. Why do we care? Some small independent businesses have simple cash registers, some just a cash drawer. Servers and store clerks may be expected to manually create a dining check or sales receipt, use the tax table accurately to add the tax, and then total the bill. In this course, you'll learn subtotaling a customer receipt, how to figure the amount of tax to be paid on that subtotal using a tax table, the amount of sale column, the tax column, entering the tax below the subtotal, totaling the customer's receipt, and where to look for a tax table. Three examples follow. First hypothetical. Diners have asked for their bill. You have added the menu items together on this sample restaurant check. The subtotal for food and drink is $19.96. It's circled for our use. And as the Beatles say, then there's the tax man. Now it's time to add Uncle Sam's required contribution, the tax, to get the total amount the customer has to pay for dinner out. It's easy if you know how to use a tax table. This is a tax table. Consult this table anytime tax is not automatically calculated. Look in the amount of sale column for the check's subtotal, $19.96. The cells each cover a range, so your specific subtotal might not be listed, but fall in a range. The tax column to the right lists the tax to be applied as $1.42. Add the tax from the tax table, $1.42, to the total, which gives you the total amount that the customer owes, $21.38. Second hypothetical, the power blacks out due to extreme heat. You're working at the camp store at a local RV park. Campers come in for ice and cold drinks. You get out your handy manual order pad. Joe comes in for ice, one soda, and a six-pack of beer. The $9.73 totals circled for our use. Look in the amount of sale column for the range of the receipt's subtotal, $9.73. The tax column to the right lists the tax to be applied as 69 cents. Add the tax from the tax table, 69 cents, to the total, which gives you the total amount that the customer owes, $10.42. Third hypothetical. Summer craft fairs can be lucrative and fun, but often there's no electricity for cash registers. With a tax table, you can still accurately make a sale. The customer doesn't even want a receipt for your hand-thrown iced tea dispenser, so this is just for your records. The $28.95 totals circled for our use. Look in the amount of sale column for the receipt's subtotal, $28.95. The tax column to the right list the tax to be applied as $2.06. Add the tax from the tax table, $2.06, to the total, which gives you the total amount that the customer owes, $31.01. Tax table storage, anywhere, perhaps posted on a wall that's near an area where employees total their paperwork. Restaurant servers might cut out only the portion of the table that they normally use and then tape it inside their order booklet. Sometimes tax tables can be stored in an easy-to-find location. Here it's stowed just under the cash register drawer. It's good to know the tax rate in your area. Sometimes the tax rate is printed in the lower left-hand column of the sales receipt. the tax rate can vary from less than 1% in some states to over 10% in some cities in California. Check with your cashier supervisor or manager for more specifics. For further information, many states and counties offer tax rate information on their websites. There may be a chart similar to the one used in this course that you can download and print out. To review using a tax table, look in the amount of sale column for the check's subtotal. The tax column to the right lists the tax to be applied. So that's it for how to use a tax table. Now, go to www.makingchange.mobi. Register to take the 10-question quiz on how to use a tax table to show your depth of knowledge. For job interviews, print an emailed transcript. Thanks for the help of Tramway Market, Kingsbury Grades, State Line, Nevada, and Bill Lowe. Please send comments, suggestions, or new topic ideas to info@makingchange.mobi. Thanks for viewing How to Use a Tax Table, and best of luck out there.